Hey guys, Andrew here from FireRocker Studios. Today we're gonna be talking about the Minecraft 1.11 update news, as well as everything that has come out so far in the snapshot 16W32A, as well as some Minecraft suggestions in today's video. Now before I get started, today we're doing a super epic giveaway. I am giving away a $20 Steam gift code to one lucky person in the comment section of this video. Now to win, the only thing you have to do is 1. Slap that like button, and 2. Let me know if you could have anything added in the 1.11 update, what would it be? And also, let me know what do you guys think about Angry Birds 2. This giveaway is actually sponsored and brought to you by the awesome people at Rovio, the creators of Angry Birds and Angry Birds 2. So I'm going to talk about them in just a second, guys, because I'm super excited today. But yeah, I'm going to go over all of the news, and then I'm going to go over the suggestions. As you can see, I am in the Mo Creatures mod because I wanted to showcase some of the mobs that they have here, like the ghost and the werewolf back there. But we'll get to that towards the later part of this video. Let me know in the comments down below, guys, what do you guys think about Angry Birds 2, and what do you guys want to see in the 1.11 update? Your comment could be featured in next week's video, and you could actually win the $20 Steam gift code giveaway. Now, let's go real quick and talk about Angry Birds 2 before I get started with the news. So, the Angry Birds are literally back in the sequel to the biggest mobile game of all time. Angry Birds 2 starts a brand new era of slingshot gameplay with super fun, stunning graphics, challenging multi-stage levels, scheming boss pigs, and even more destruction. Guys, I've been playing this game all week. It is a ton of fun. I highly recommend you guys check it out, not just because I'm sponsored, but because I genuinely love Angry Birds. I played the first game literally religiously. It was so much fun. Guys, go to the link in the description of this video. You guys can actually download Angry Birds 2 for free. It is their 1-year anniversary, so there's free cake as well. Now, the game is so amazing, guys. I really do recommend it. This is my honest opinion. I'm not getting paid to say this. I genuinely love the game. The graphics are insane. All the new birds have a bunch of really cool tricks. They have some of the ones from the original game. Some of them are brand new and have awesome features. It's a ton of fun, guys. The game has literally been downloaded over 100 million times. I'm literally a huge fan of Angry Birds. I want to get myself a couple of the plushie games or the plushies from the movies and in general and put them in the back of my actual like office and decorate them. It's a ton of fun, guys. I really recommend you guys check out the game. And yeah, it's been a 1-year anniversary that they've had it, so definitely go check it out. Let me know in the comment section, what do you guys think about the game? I personally got to level 20 within like, I think 15 minutes. I was like speed running it, and it's a ton of fun, so definitely check it out. Really awesome game. Links to it is in the description down below of this video. But yeah, thank you to the awesome people at Rovio for sponsoring this video, guys. Let me know in the comments, what do you guys personally think about Angry Birds, and what level are you guys on in Angry Birds 2? Let me know. I'm currently, I believe, in level 25. I'm still playing. Every time I get bored, I always jump on. So let me know what level you guys are on. But without further ado, let's talk about the Minecraft 1.11 snapshot 16W32A. I'm going to go over all the change logs, even though I made a video earlier this week, so that you guys are up to date with all the news. And then we're going to get started with the actual suggestions part of today's video. So first things first, Jeb actually tweeted out earlier this week, right after the snapshot came out, saying 1.11 will be slightly bigger than 1.10, but still a relatively small update, which is good to know. By the way, there's a werewolf back there that's turning into a werewolf. But yeah, so we know that the snapshot, or at least this update 1.11, will be out a lot faster than the previous 1.8 and 1.9 updates, but it is going to be a little bit bigger than 1.10, so we're probably going to get it right as soon as Minecon comes out. Probably we'll have one or two snapshots, and then it'll be a full release. I just love this mod, by the way, guys. I just want to showcase it. But yeah, so going over all the things that they've changed so far in the snapshot, the 1.11 update snapshot 16W32A, here is the exact change logs. I'm going to go over it real quick. Some mobs are now more afraid to get wet in water, which basically means mobs are, I guess, their AI is programmed so that they stay away from water, at least a little bit better than before. There are now more spawn eggs for different mobs, and the time that they are working, and this time they're working properly, so I guess that's good. Mob types are now separated like this: Guardian and Elder Guardian, Skeleton, Stray, and Wither Skeleton, Zombie, Zombie Villager, and Husk, for examples. They've also changed the duration of hunger and saturation effects. They broke some bugs so that they should not happen anymore. Basically, they fixed a couple of bugs. Resource pack format changed slightly. It is now using version 3. And then most commands can now use block state definitions instead of numerical metadata values. So the snapshot basically was a lot of technical stuff and bugs that were fixed. They also made it so that snowmen are now 10% less derpy, so they've improved their air API a little bit more. More robust handling of invalid items, and hopefully less dumping bugs due to this change. I don't really know what they mean by that, but I don't know. Lightning storms will now attract less skeleton horses, so I guess that is the last of the changes to the snapshot 16W32A. So there we go. That's everything that has been added in this first snapshot. They're probably going to be releasing a snapshot this following Wednesday as well. As the making of this video, it is currently August 13th, so if people are watching, because I know I recorded last week's videos in the beginning of the week, week before the snapshot actually came out. So in all those videos, I kind of have a little bit of late news, so I tried to correct myself the best way I can. But yeah, without further ado, let's start with the suggestions part of today's video. So over here, I've got the Mo Creatures mod. These are wraiths. They're basically ghosts, and they're pretty awesome. I wanted to showcase this because we really haven't gotten a new hostile mob, not including the variations of the skeleton and the zombie, because in 1.10, we got a husk mob, which is a different type of zombie that spawns in dry biomes, and we got the stray mob, which is a different type of skeleton, which spawns in cold biomes. But we haven't really gotten a new hostile mob in the 1.10 update. I mean, we technically got the shocker mob for the end cities in 1.9, and we got the guardian mob in 1.8 for the underwater temples. So we technically have been getting a new hostile mob in every single update so far, with 1.10 being the husk and the stray mob. But I think it'd be cool still to get some type of transparent mob, like a ghost, and I think these are pretty cool in the mod itself. So this is the Mo Creatures mod, and they have a bunch of other variations of really cool mobs. If you walk over here, you can actually see there is a golem over here, which actually absorbs blocks from around its area, and like, oh my god, that's so cool. As you can see, it's literally sucking up all the blocks from around this section to form its actual gigantic golem body, which I personally think it's amazing. I can't believe that Dr. Zark's mod is as awesome as this. Like, we literally never see anything this awesome in Minecraft, so this is one of the things that I think it's super awesome. The only thing that's anywhere as cool as this would have to be maybe the wither scout or the wither that you can fight in Minecraft, but it literally absorbs blocks and it shoots them at you, which I just think is awesome. And in general, the effects are awesome. Let me know, guys, in the comment section down below, if you could add any of the hostile mobs that I've shown you today in the Mo Creatures mod into Minecraft 1.11, what would it be? Personally, it would be this giant golem, because I think this is absolutely amazing. I also do like the ogres that they have over here, which if I go ahead and hit this guy, you can see he smashes the ground around him and he makes a big explosion, kind of like, oh my god, I just realized that golem just killed him. Okay, well, I'm gonna walk away from that. They also have scorpions, they have the original mobs as well, because this is still Minecraft. We've got a werewolf right over here, which if I make it daytime, he will actually transform. Actually, there's two werewolves. Let me do slash time set 106. So you can see, they actually transform back into their human form, because they are werewolves. So there we go, that is how a werewolf looks when it is in its normal state. And if I go ahead and make it nighttime, they will actually transform into werewolves. As you can see, that guy is already transforming from a human form into a werewolf, which I think that is so cool. Like, guys, let me know in the comments down below, would you guys like to see a mob that actually transforms from daytime to nighttime? Because we have mobs that change their behavior depending on the time of day. For example, if you see a spider just walking around during the daytime, it's not gonna hurt you unless you attack it. But at nighttime, they become hostile. Very much how, like, wolves, I think at nighttime they're hostile, but during the day they're friendly, so you can go ahead and beat them and you won't have a problem with them. I don't know if they've changed that in recent updates, because it's been such a while since I looked into them. But still, I think that's pretty cool. We've got some natural wraiths just over here all flying around, and this one's pretty cool. This one has a different texture. But guys, let me know in the comment section down below, what do you guys think about adding ghosts or wraiths, whatever you want to call them, into the actual game? They have so many mobs here. I think there's a mummy. Is this a mummy? This is a different type of skeleton, which goes to show they already had different types of skeletons in the Mo Creatures mod, and now they actually added different types of skeletons into the actual game in 1.10, which goes to show if things are popular enough and good enough, they'll eventually be added into the actual game. I wonder what is shooting at me. Oh, it's that guy over there. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this video up, guys. So you guys can probably expect to get a brand new Enderman in the 1.11 update. That's just a prediction that I predict we're gonna probably get a new Enderman, because I've talked about it before, we have regular creepers, we have charged creepers when they get hit by lightning, we have zombie pigmen, zombies, husk zombies, and we have skeletons. What other types of skeletons? Skeletons, wither skeletons from the nether, and then we also have the stray skeleton that came out in 1.10. So we have different variations of almost all the mobs except Enderman. So I predict we're probably going to be getting a new type of Enderman, or maybe more variations of pre-existing mobs. But guys, that's pretty much it for this suggestions video. I wanted to showcase all these. If you guys want to download the mod, links to it is in the description down below. Like I said earlier today, guys, make sure to check out Angry Birds 2. Links to the game is in the description down below. Go click on it, check it out. It's a super awesome game. I'm personally a huge fan of it. I hope you guys love it as much as I do. Let me know what level you guys are currently on, and that's pretty much it for this. Like always, guys, I upload videos every single day, so check out the subscription box, guys. Subscribe, that way you guys get notified when I upload a new video. That's pretty much it for me. Like always, I'm Andrew from Fire Rocker Studios. You guys are rockers. Check out the description, hit that button for subscription, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye!